Then, first responders whose heroism on 9/11 left them with potentially deadly illnesses are exposing how the government isn't helping them get the medical care they desperately need.
On 9/11 are now sick with respiratory ailments and other life-threatening illnesses. And they say they're not getting the care they so desperately need. Please welcome to the show Vito Valenti and Bonnie Gibfried. Hello, guys.
Hello, Vito. Hello,
Hi.
Bonnie.
Hi, Bonnie.
Bonnie, you are EMT workers, now a volunteer. What was your position before 9/11?
I was a EMT. I was dispatched through the 911 system from Flushing Hospital Medical Center. I went from 164th Street and Northern Boulevard into the city through the LIE, down to what we know as now is Ground Zero. Uh-huh. Originally, I was supposed to be staged on West and Vesey.
Right.
And by the grace of God, at that point, a firefighter stopped me in the middle of West and Liberty, put me on top of a manhole cover, which I know you're not supposed to be on. And I tried to get underneath the pedestrian bridge, and that's where my ambulance ended up getting blown under.
So you were buried alive underneath the debris?
I was buried alive on the outside of Financial One.
For how long were you under there?
We don't know. It was probably about 10 minutes, because with the debris burning at that point and us being trapped by tons of stuff,
right,
it cut off the oxygen completely.
So how was your health before, and how is it now? Tell
us. I passed 4 physicals. I passed the fire department in New York. I passed my volunteer firefighter exam. Mm-hmm. I passed my exam for my job through Flushing Hospital. And I had another physical that I deal with other people. And I passed 4 physicals before 9/11.
So you were completely healthy?
I played on three softball
teams.
Okay,
so now what is the status of your health?
I'm lucky if I can walk up the stairs someday.
You have respiratory illness. And is there a name for the respiratory illness that you have?
They call it RADS, reactive airway disease, or the WTC cough you've heard. Asthma. I have chronic asthma now.
Did you have it before?
No.
No. Vito, where were you when 9/11 happened?
I was at 125 Barclay Street. I worked for DC 37, Local 372 Schools Division. I was a grievance representative, and we took care of all the city schools.
You went down there and were down there for how long?
2 days. I was there for 2 days.
And what was your job?
I did search and rescue. I volunteered.
You were a volunteer. When you were gigged down there, were you given a mask?
I was not given nothing.
Really?
The only thing they gave us was a purple, the orange vests.
Yes.
That's it.
And at that time?
No gloves, no mask, no respirator.
Did you have a sense you should have some of that equipment? But you couldn't get it.
We couldn't get it.
As EMS, we weren't given equipment either.
Yeah,
at that time, had Christy Whitman said that it was safe? Had it been declared safe down there? Because shortly after 9/11, the air was considered safe. Is that true, Dr. Mulley?
That's what was said a few days later when they were down there. It was too early, and the air certainly wasn't safe. It wasn't safe for many, many months down at Ground Zero.
We should say that this is Dr. Jacqueline Moline, and she is the director of the WFC Monitoring and Treatment Program at Mount Sinai.
So you've been monitoring the first response workers, people who were down there, who now have these respiratory diseases. Over half the people who were down there are now suffering the way these two people are?
We've seen it in thousands of people from the New York area and responders throughout the whole country who came in and have now gone back to their communities. This is a national problem. People are sick. They have upper respiratory problems. They have cough, asthma, reactive airway disease. People have scarring in their lungs and serious diseases requiring lung transplants, like Vito is going to require.
You need a lung transplant.
I was diagnosed with pulmonary fibrosis. I need a double lung transplant.
Now, before 9/11, had you had any disease like this?
No.
You two were a healthy man.
I was healthy because in the city schools, the old school, you know, the old and the newer schools today, they got elevators. The old schools, you know, we were in charge of like school aides, cafeteria. So when I went to see the principal, I might have had to walk on a 4th floor.
Yeah, right.
Today, I'm lucky if I can walk.
No,
this is what
can't.
I carry.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I'm diagnosed with pulmonary fibrosis, restricted air. I got lesions on my leg that, I mean, I could show you. This is some of the stuff I'm battling.
Now, doctor, what would these lesions be caused from? Related to the 9/11, Dr. Moline?
Well, without going into Vito's whole medical history, it's hard to know exactly, but it's all part and parcel of someone who has chronic lung disease, because the heart isn't able to pump as well, and the blood flow getting back to the lungs. So you have the blood flow builds up, the legs get swollen, and then you're more likely to get skin problems in the lower legs.
That's what happened to you.
As my doctor also said, now on top of that, my heart is very, very enlarged. I can't sleep. I haven't laid down in a bed, laying down for almost 4 years. I sleep every night in a chair.
Sitting up.
I sit up like this.
The average number is what, 20,000 people? Is that the number that we're talking about?
Well, we know there are about 50,000 responders. There are estimates
50,000 responders.
And we know that about half of them continue to have some type of symptom up at the time, and people have cough. We used to know who had been at the World Trade Center in our office because we would hear them coughing.
No kidding.
So, when we come back, we want to talk about the federal funding, because that is really the tragedy here also.
Right, because we need federal funding for this, and it's coming up soon in the Senate. And no matter what you feel about this government, we need to take care of these people who went down there to help us as
volunteer.
Those buildings were attacked.
They volunteer.
Yes, we're gonna come back with them and tell a little bit more what you can do and about their story. Don't go away. We're back with Vito and Bonnie, and first 9/11 first responders who are suffering now from terrible illness. And Dr. Moline, you were saying in order to continue your studies about the effects of the 911 rescue on people's lungs, you are going to need funding.
Right, not only to continue to monitor the health, we're going to need to monitor the health of these responders for the next 20 to 30 years, but we also need to treat them. We can't just monitor their health, we need to treat them. And now we finally received federal funding in the fall. That was a start.
Last fall?
In November.
Uh-huh.
We had some philanthropic funding. That funding is now over. Federal funding is in place, but that's not going to last through the end of the year.
How much did you get?
We, at Mount Sinai, we got about $17 million, but program-wise, there was about $50 million was given for funding, and this was for fire department, has a sister program to the Mount Sinai Consortium, and there are a number of medical centers that have programs to treat responders, and also there's a national program.
But now, are they treated for free, or is this covered by their insurance, or do they pay out of pocket to try to get better from this?
Currently, they're able to be covered under the federal program, totally covered. Everything is free. There's no co-pays, no out-of-pocket expenses for their World Trade Center-related problems. That money is estimated to run out this year,
uh-huh.
and possibly this fiscal year, the government fiscal year. So we're concerned that we're not going to have enough money to continue to treat the patients that are now finally getting the care that they need. Many of them couldn't afford the care that they needed.
How much do you need?
There's been a lot of number crunching, and the numbers have estimated to be at $250 million a year to cover mm-hmm. all responders for all their World Trade Center problems in New York City, including the fire department, and also those responders nationwide.
And that money has been earned by every single person who went down there to help. And I know the firefighters talk about their metal boots burning through. The firefighter boots, they had to get new boots as they burned through those toxins that were ingested into your bodies. And, you know, we have to stand up as a nation and support these men and women.
Well,
we do.
You bring up the fact of the toxins. There was 258,000 toxins identified, which they're carcinogens. A carcinogen and a carcinogen makes more death.
Uh-huh. Right.
They do not know what these chemicals combine do to us. And it is wreaking havoc not only on us, but our families are being dismembered. We have children cutting themselves because they can't deal with it. We have children drinking and drugging. We have children committing suicide.
We
have
effect.
Members uh-huh. of family. When does the terror end? I'm watching my friends every day die, and I'm going to start crying.
Right. It is unbelievable.
Every day.
It's unreal. It really is. And I have to say, for all of America, thank you for going and responding. Those first responders, they deserve so much better treatment than they're given now. Anything you can do, please write and support the Dr. Jacqueline Moline. I wish there was more I could say or do, and believe me, next year that's going to be a focus for me, helping the 911 responders.
Yeah.
Well, thank you both for being here, and we will be right back. Look it up, Google, email, write someone. We can change this, America. We can. Oh, it's so hard.